So who began preaching the pre-tribulation rapture anyway? Well, the first preacher on record to have ever taught the pre-tribulation rapture was a man by the name of John Nelson Darby. Now, John Nelson Darby started preaching this in the 1830s, and he's known as the father of modern dispensationalism. What's interesting about him is that later on he would go on to put out his own version of the Bible. It's called the Darby Translation. And in this version, he severely corrupted God's word. He removed entire verses, removed entire phrases from the Bible. He tampered with key doctrines, like for example, in Luke 2:33, he calls Joseph Jesus's father, basically attacking the doctrine of the deity of Jesus Christ and the virgin birth, which the King James Bible carefully teaches us in Luke chapter 2, verse 33. But he also tampered with passages that have to do with the end times. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, one of the most damning scriptures to the pre-tribulation doctrine, he completely rewrote it to prop up his doctrine and to hide the fact that the Bible warns us about this deception. And so I can guarantee you one thing. John Nelson Darby's burning in hell right now, because the Bible says this in Revelation 22, verse 18. For I testify unto every man that heareth the words of the prophecy of this book. If any man shall add unto these things, God shall add unto him the plagues that are written in this book. And if any man shall take away from the words of the book of this prophecy, God shall take away his part out of the book of life, and out of the holy city, and from the things which are written in this book. The Bible's clear that when an unsaved man, a false prophet, a false teacher, when they begin to remove from and add to God's word, their fate is sealed. The Bible says they will be damned. Their part is removed from the book of life and from the holy city. All the plagues of the book of Revelation are added unto them. And so anyone who tampers with the word of God loses their opportunity to ever get saved. Now, of course, I don't believe a person can lose their salvation. The Bible's clear when Jesus said, I give unto them eternal life, and they shall never perish, neither shall any man pluck them out of my hand. But when an unsaved person tampers with God's word, adds to or removes from, the Bible says they can never be saved. They've lost their opportunity to be saved. The part where their name would have even been in the book of life is gone. And so I don't believe a saved person would ever add to or remove from God's word. That's something that a wicked, reprobate, false prophet or false teacher would do. No man speaking by the Spirit of God calleth Jesus Christ accursed. And no man who has the Holy Spirit living inside of them is going to set out to remove from and add to God's word, like a Joseph Smith who added, you know, another testament of Jesus Christ. It's all lies. John Nelson Darby added to and took from God's word in hundreds of places. He took out entire verses from the Bible. He twisted passages to support his pre-tribulation rapture doctrine, 2 Thessalonians 2, for example. And therefore, he is burning in hell. He's been damned.